When a gas is flowing over a body or a body is moving in the fluid, disturbances will be generated. These disturbances will propagate within the flow and interact with other parts of the body. Such flow disturbances are called waves, and their motion is referred to as wave motion. The wave motion has a significant effect on the dynamics of gas flow because it can profoundly affect the forces and thermal loads on the body in the flow environment. In general, the wave motion in compressible flows is complicated, and its fundamental physics and mechanisms need to be understood and correctly described by predictive methods. For this purpose, the one-dimensional governing equations of gas dynamics and derived results will be utilized for the understanding and analysis of wave motion in this course. But before diving into these mathematical formulations and equations, let us first talk about the basic features of two different compressible waves, that are shock waves and expansion waves. As mentioned earlier, compressible waves are essentially the disturbances in the flow. The shock wave is a type of flow disturbance that propagates through the gas faster than the local speed of sound. Consider an object moving through a fluid at a supersonic speed. Waves due to the motion of this object cannot affect upstream because they propagate at the speed of sound and are therefore slower than the object itself. As a result, these waves coalesce a short distance in front of the object and form a very thin wave front. This is called a shock wave, or simply a shock. The lag of wave fronts behind the object restricts these waves into a cone-shaped region, which is called a Mach cone. The wave fronts at the edge of this Mach cone coalesce into a shock wave that is the downstream part of the front shock and is referred to as a bow shock. Now, if you are standing outside of the Mach cone, you will not hear any sound. This region is called the zone of silence. There are three different types of shock waves. The normal shocks are oriented perpendicular to the flow direction, whereas the oblique shocks are inclined with the flow. A bow shock is generally positioned upstream, away from the stagnation point of the body, and arcs away from its position as an oblique shock. Please note that more than one type of shock waves can appear simultaneously in the flow. Let us now look at the fundamental characteristics of shock waves. Firstly, the thickness of a shock wave is very small. According to the measurements, a typical thickness of a shock is in the order of magnitude of the mean free path of molecules. Moreover, shock waves result in a sudden change in flow properties across them. For example, the magnitude of static properties such as pressure, temperature, and density increase sharply across the shock, and so does the flow entropy. Now, on the contrary, the Mach number and total pressure of the flow decreases suddenly downstream of the shock. Because of this reason, the shock waves are treated as discontinuities in the continuum description of gas dynamics. Besides supersonic flow, a sudden release of energy is another mechanism of generating a shock wave. In this scenario, the energy is dissipated into the ambient environment through an expanding shock. A subsonic flow is present at the downstream side of the shock. One typical example of this type of shock is blast waves that are created by massive explosions. However, the release energy does not have to be huge to generate a shock. It just needs to be released suddenly. For instance, within a few microseconds. One interesting example is the popping sound you hear when popping an air balloon or stomping on a packaging air pillow. That popping sound is the shock wave hitting your eardrums. A similar example is the bursting sound or shock wave that is generated when a firecracker suddenly explodes. Another type of compressible wave that we are going to cover in this lesson is the expansion wave. Expansion waves, also frequently called expansion fans, are formed when supersonic flow meets a sudden expanding area. For example, when the flow turns around a convex corner. As the flow turns away from itself, a series of expansion waves are formed at the corner and expands away like a fan. Just like shock waves, the flow properties change at the downstream side of the expansion fan. As we can see, the Mach number increases, but at the same time, the static pressure, temperature, and density decrease. The expansion fan is basically a mechanism for supersonic flow to expand without violating the laws of thermodynamics. So, in this lesson, we covered the basic concepts of waves in compressible flows and two different compressible waves, that is shocks and expansion waves, were described. We will get into more details on these waves in the following lessons of this course.